Tonight's headlines are brought to you in part by Coldwell Energy and McDonald's.
Good evening, Commonwealth, and thanks for watching the Channel 2 News. I'm Sally Lemus. Let's take a look at tonight's top stories. What is China's influence on the NMI? U.S. senators want to know. Also tonight, Omicron is here. It's been here, but what does it mean? And a major company makes a major donation to the Pacific Mini Games. In sports, NMI Soccer gets ready for a regional ruckus. Stay with us, these stories and more are next here on the Channel 2 News.
There you have it. McDonald's new crispy chicken sandwich. From the makers of the world's most stolen fries. The juicy chicken sandwich from the place that offers extra napkins for a reason. The tender chicken sandwich from the creators of a sandwich phenomenon. So you won't just be biting into a chicken sandwich. You'll be biting into McDonald's new crispy, juicy, tender chicken sandwich. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
Half a day to the WAMI and good evening, Commonwealth. Today is Friday, February 4th, 2022. This week, U.S. senators questioned the influence of China on the Mariana Islands. Finance Secretary David Attlee was in the hot seat.
The U.S. Senate Committee on Energy and Natural Resources held a hearing in Washington this week to examine the state of U.S. territories. Finance Secretary David Attlee represented the CNMI, and he was asked some hard-hitting questions on China's influence in the Marianas. Senator James Langford from Oklahoma asks about immigration policy, labor laws, and traffic of Chinese nationals, specifically during the build-up of Imperial Pacific International. Let's take a look at the Q&A.
So go back 2019 and before, because we saw a pretty rapid rise of Chinese nationals construction. I know there were several different challenges with labor laws being violated with the 45-day basically visa process to be able to come from China, that we saw some Chinese companies coming and doing construction, bringing in Chinese nationals, not paying them basic wages there, and then moving back and forth. What do you anticipate happens once we get to the other side of COVID, even so, Lord come, when that day comes? What do you anticipate happens? Do we return right back to that again?
No. Thank you for that question. This pandemic gave us an opportunity to revisit a lot of the policies we have as a Commonwealth. And one of the issues is in our tourism sector, obviously. You know, we had issues with, you know, unregistered Airbnbs and attracting foreigners from coming in. And we've working very closely with the Governor's Council of Economic Advisors that are looking at different policies and issues to correct things. It gives us an opportunity to reset and make some policy decisions to better and improve on some of those issues.
Langford then goes on to ask about birth tourism in the CNMI and what they can do to resolve them.
2009, when the new visa process came into place on that, with Chinese nationals able to come in faster and easier into the process. My understanding from the records that we can find, and we haven't found all records on this, but my understanding from the records that foreign individuals that were foreign born coming into the islands and having a child, there were 10 in 2009, but by 2018, there were 600. That there seemed to be an influx of individuals coming from China to the Northern Mariana Islands, having a child there. Obviously, that's significant for us in the United States if a Chinese national is actually coming in to be able to have a child there. Have you seen that trend? Where's that trend in 2019? That's the year we don't have. Did that continue once we reopen again at post-COVID? What happens with that type of tourism?
That's an excellent question. I think what we've done locally is address that. Our Commonwealth Health Center has spiked the cost for foreigners to get services in our hospitals for delivery and things of that nature has spiked up. It has reduced the number. You gotta also think, keep in mind, we don't control our borders in terms of immigration.
Right.
And so when these people come in and go through, you know, customs and border patrol, we're stuck with the challenges that was allowed to be brought in.
What do you need from us to be able to help you? Obviously, raising the price in the hospitals and everything else for delivery costs, there's a lot of folks who be willing to pay a lot of money to be able to have American citizenship. I get that, and have access to the rest of the country. What do you need from us to be able to help you in these challenges?
I think we need some policy changes and control a little bit more flexibility in our control of the borders. As we've had that control in the past, we didn't have that issue prior to that. But I think, Senator Langford, I this is a question that I'll bring back to our leaders and be responsible to give you a great response.
Okay. Well, I'd very much appreciate that. Obviously, we don't want to hurt tourism. That's a major feature of the economy, and we understand that, want to be able to recover again. But we want to be able to protect the integrity of the workforce, what's actually happening there, and also the multitude of issues with birth tourism.
Senator Roger Marshall from Kansas directs his question onto potential military installation and illegal fishing.
Are you concerned about China's moves in the Pacific with regards to your neighbors, where China might try and build military installations or expand illegal fishing? And what would that mean to the economy and your nation's and your security?
Thank you, Senator. We are in the same sentiment as the territory of Guam. We share the same waters and the same distance. We're just half an hour flight away. But to the question of the economic dominance that they're trying to do in other neighboring islands, I don't have a straight answer from our position. We do know that other islands are benefiting, you know, financially in terms of economic input into their economy. But we're under the U.S. flag, so we seek to this body for our assistance, and we continue to build on our partnerships.
Long suspected but now confirmed, the Omicron variant is present in the NMI. Officials say they also anticipate breakthrough infections.
The Omicron variant has been present in the CNMI since December of last year. According to regional epidemiologist Stephanie Kern-Ali, this shouldn't be much of a surprise since Omicron has spread throughout the Pacific region.
This variant is very good at sneaking in. It's very good at spreading. And it can really spread like wildfire in a community.
Local officials state the Omicron surge is coming. Some important things to know about Omicron is it is 2 times faster to spread than the Delta variant. Also with Omicron, individuals who have recovered from COVID in the past may get it again.
Can quickly spread from person to person much more efficiently than some of the other variants that we've seen. We also know that there are some treatments that are less effective against this virus, and so we're now using different treatments that we do have here on island that are effective against it. And we know that we expect breakthrough infections in people who are fully vaccinated with this from this Omicron variant. But we do know from some of the data I'll be presenting that those vaccines are incredibly effective at preventing severe illness, hospitalizations, and death.
Hospital Chief Esther Munoz states the priority now is to ensure that one can recover from the virus.
Our goal here is to try to get preventive measures and treatment to individuals. We have the therapeutic treatments, and we are also offering testing. Individuals can find out and prevent the spread by getting tested if they have the symptoms and isolating. And working, you know, and also getting accessing the cares, the services that we have, as well as getting your booster shots.
Ali states COVID-19 vaccinations are effective against this disease.
We know that vaccine effectiveness wanes over time. We can see that Omicron is in the red there. And after 6 months after dose two, our full series of vaccination efficacy against effectiveness against Omicron infection dropped to 57%. And after that booster shot, it's back up to 90% effectiveness against this disease. So we know we really encourage folks to go ahead and take advantage of those booster doses.
The public is highly encouraged to continue to live COVID safe. Practice the 3 W's, avoid crowds and poorly ventilated spaces, and cover whenever you cough or sneeze. Make sure to clean and disinfect high-touch surfaces on a daily and be alert for symptoms. The CNMI has the capacity to test community members, so get tested if you can.
A major donation comes into the Pacific Mini Games. Our Chris Nelson has more.
We are making history, and you are part of it.
Beginning June 17th, the NMI will host countries from around the Pacific competing in 9 sports, including baseball, golf, tennis, and beach volleyball.
Overjoyed and so proud that our islands, the Northern Marianas, is hosting the Pacific Mini Games this year. It's important to the Jotun Dai-Dai Foundation and the Athletes Foot Saipan to help support and promote our islands by encouraging health and wellness through these sporting events at the mini games. This is such an amazing opportunity to showcase our island pride.
Jotun Dai-Dai Foundation is investing in the games as a major sponsor.
And with that, I would like to announce our commitment in becoming a platinum sponsor today by donating $100,000 towards the Northern Marianas Pacific Mini Games.
We look at this as going to be international games. And being from Saipan, and Saipan being our home island, this is going to become a showcase for the Commonwealth.
Tennis will be one of the favorites to medal, anchored around Colin Sinclair and Carol Lee. Both won gold medals in Apia, Samoa, 2019. Baseball team also looking forward to taking care of business on our home field. Other sports featured at the games include weightlifting, badminton, triathlon, and athletics.
We are humbled with the gesture that Jotun Dai-Dai has stepped forward for this historical event that's going to be happening in the Marianas.
Ben Babauta says a lot of work is going into getting the venues ready for the June competition.
There's a lot of planning, organizing, and operational that we continue to facilitate on a daily basis. Mm-hmm. First and foremost, the venue, the competition venue. Everyone's working really hard behind the scenes.
That work includes renovations at the Olei Sports Complex, American Memorial Park tennis courts, the baseball field, and work on Rota and Tinian as well.
I think, being in business for the last 73 years, I think it's appropriate for us to show the love of our country and to showcase our community and our Commonwealth.
The games will be a chance to show off the beauty and brains of the NMI to the rest of our Pacific Island nations and to the world. Tonight, we'd like to debut a new video produced in conjunction with the Games Committee that gives a preview of what's coming. 3, 2, and 1. Coming up, we talk about tourists in the NMI. Stay tuned.
Need a new phone? Trade in now and get up to $500 off our best 5G devices. Trade in your older phone in any condition and step up to better savings and speeds only our 5G network can provide. Check out our website and catch up on the best mobile experience. Trade in now. Docomo Pacific, better together.
Hey, golfers, come north and practice your game at the Marianas Driving Range. New Year's local specials. 10-piece coupon books available for just $60. That's a $10 savings. Want to get really good? Come work on your swing every day for just $99 per month. It's our practice pass, and you're going to love it. Grab your passes and go straight to the range. You can social distance and chip all at the same time, and the views are free. Reserve now at marianastrekking.com. You can pay online, open 7 days a week.
The COVID-19 vaccine is a great way to diminish the spread of the coronavirus and getting our daily lives back to normal.
People to feel safe and comfortable when they're around me. I understand that there's so much anxiety surrounding COVID, and I want to do my part in reducing that anxiety.
I wanted to protect myself,
my patients,
my family,
and my coworkers.
I have students who also have underlying health issues, and I know that this is my responsibility to take care of myself, but also to protect them and their families.
I encourage our community to go and get vaccinated, for it is our greatest hope to conquer the spread of coronavirus.
Get vaccinated, ask questions, do it for our community.
For the Marianas.
Get vaccinated, CNMI.
Welcome back to the Channel 2 News. In February, Korean carriers are flying into the Marianas twice per week, and tourism officials hope that the flights can not only continue, but increase. But is the NMI ready?
In the coming months, businesses are hoping to see more tourists, but how many are ready? Managa is currently without an operator after previous bidders withdrew. Many of the bigger attractions are closed, and most places in Garapan also still closed. Joe Guerrero of the Saipan Chamber of Commerce says it won't happen overnight, but businesses are getting ready.
I think one of the things is really to support the tourism frontliners, which are the hotels and the operators of these properties. From my interviews and discussions with them, they are prepared. It's going to take a little bit time to ramp up, but with hard work, they will get through it. They will recruit the workers that they need. There's a lot of emphasis on recruiting U.S. qualified workers and training students on board, and so it's not going to be an overnight fix. Long-term prospects and even mid-term prospects are very good, I believe. And I think I speak on behalf of a lot of the hotel operators and tourism partners that it's going to be a struggle starting up, but we will get there.
After a three-year vacancy, Guam selects a new chief medical examiner.
The Postmortem Commission has selected Dr. Jeffrey Nine to serve as the chief medical examiner of Guam. Nine has been offered the position with a salary of $310,000 per annum. Attorney General Edward Manibusen confirms with Guam that his office will provide $50,000 in exchange for forensic pathology services to the NMI. No word yet on Nine's confirmation on the offer. Dr. Kenny Su, the candidate previously selected last year, declined the offer. Sue expressed concerns over the Office of Chief Medical Examiner's budget and facility. The last Chief Medical Examiner was Dr. Aurelio Espinola. Espinola provided several services to the CNMI, performing autopsies on found bodies.
More than 500 cases of positive COVID-19 have been confirmed by the CHCC in just 2 days.
CHCC reports 261 additional cases of COVID-19 on Thursday evening, along with 252 cases on Wednesday evening. 6 of these cases were identified on Tinian and 20 on Rota. As of February 3, there are 1,300 active cases of COVID and 10 hospitalizations. None are on a ventilator. With the Omicron variant now present in the CNMI, officials urge residents to get tested. To register for community-based testing, you may visit covidtesting.chcc.health. No code is required to register. The Department of Fire and Emergency Medical Services also conduct COVID testing as well on Mondays, Wednesdays, and Saturdays. You may visit the fire stations at Susupi, Garapan, and Cagman.
All right, folks, don't go anywhere because we have sports up next.
Love and commitment. It's amazing how these two words can transform our lives.
The last time I was in Saipan was in July 2020 for my daughter's baptismal. With my position here at work, I'm unable to go back as much as I'd like to visit my daughter, being that there's still the lockdown still in place here in Guam.
And as long as we value these two important things, we can make wonders.
My I always talk to her when I'm cooking or when packing my lunch for work. And then when I go home and then I talk to her when I get off of work, I always ask her how her day was.
This is where we draw our strength, our happiness, our passion to make everything and every day a lot easier. It's about making every day amazing and giving that extra effort to make all the little things work. In most places, in most moments. And it's our commitment to what we love and who we love that makes us stronger together.
Green sea turtles and hawksbill turtles call the Mariana Islands home. They're an important part of the marine ecosystem. They are under threat, and they are protected under CNMI law. Keep plastic out of the ocean. Keep vehicles off the beach. Use the sea turtle stranding hotline if you see poaching activities or if you see a turtle in trouble. Call 287-8537 and save a turtle.
The Tan Sri Lin Foundation promotes the culture of giving back. The foundation and its generous partners are committed to supporting programs that include health, education, and sports. Initiatives that promote arts and culture, the environment, and tourism will benefit our community and our residents. Giving back and making a difference will help ensure that the island paradise we call home will be a better place to live.
One of the best gifts we can give ourselves is a healthy diet. At Gold's Gym, our pre- and post-workout formula is loaded into every smoothie, giving you a satisfying meal with fewer calories. Perfect to enhance a workout or replace a meal, and you don't need to be a member to visit the Shake Cafe. This month, try our Strawberry Peach Cobbler Smoothie of the Month for just $5.50. It's got great stuff in it like soy milk, strawberries, bananas, peaches, and granola. 458 calories of energy, 12 grams of fat, and 25 grams of protein. Fast food that is good for you and tastes great. Shake it up. Gold's Gym, Garibay.
Need a new phone? Trade in now and get up to $500 off our best 5G devices. Trade in your older phone in any condition and step up to better savings and speeds only our 5G network can provide. Check out our website and catch up on the best mobile experience. Trade in now. Docomo Pacific, better together.
Tonight's sports brought to you in part by Tan Holdings through the Tan Sri Lin Foundation, making communities a better place to live.
Buenas sports fans.
Tonight in our segment on Young Stars, we profile a high school student who eats, sleeps, and breathes soccer.
Once you're satisfied with your goal, it is the real happiness.
Young Stars Shining, brought to you by the Tan Sri Lin Foundation.
Desiah Mendiola is a member of the NMI women's football team. The 15-year-old is a sophomore at Mount Carmel and has been playing soccer for the last 2 years.
When I moved here, I really didn't give soccer much thought until a couple of my friends tried to convince me, and I ended up giving it a chance, and I ended up really falling in love with this sport, and it's brought me to where I am today, and I eat, sleep, and breathe on the pitch.
The team now training hard, heading off island to lace up their boots for some regional competition later this month. She says practice is getting more and more intense.
Usually before big games and like bigger competitions, our trainings are more intense and consistent, like now, 5 to 6 times, and a lot of running, a lot of conditioning, making sure you're fit mentally and physically so that you don't burn yourself out during games.
Her job on the field? Well, she's the last line of defense, goalkeeper.
It's honestly a really big honor to feel like I'm representing the scene of my island, and I also feel like it's a very big opportunity for me to expand my future, and I could really see myself getting far with it.
Young Star Shining, brought to you by the Tan Soo Lim Foundation.
Buy one, get one free for the off-road adventure at Marianas Trekking. Come ride our side-by-sides at our best price ever and experience a great 90-minute trail ride. Rain or shine, hopefully rain. Book now at Marianas Trekking. Saturdays and Sundays by reservation. Call 323-8735 or book at marianastrekking.com.
And for the KSPN weather report, partly sunny with isolated showers, east-northeast wind around 17 miles per hour with gusts as high as 23 miles per hour. Tonight, it'll be partly cloudy with isolated showers, east-northeast wind 8 to 15 miles per hour. High 85, low 75, a humidity of 74%. Tomorrow, expect mostly sunny with isolated showers, east-northeast wind 8 to 15 miles per hour. High 85 and a low 74. For the marine forecast, moderate to fresh east and to northeast winds are expected through tonight. Winds will briefly decrease Saturday before increasing again Saturday night. Combined seas of 7 to 9 feet expected today, decreasing to 6 to 8 feet tonight. The sunrise will be at 6:45 a.m., high tide 10:35 a.m., low tide at 4:33 p.m., and the sunset at 6:16 p.m.
All right, folks, there you have it. That is your weekend edition of the New Sports and Weather. We thank you so much for watching. We hope you have a good night, and we'll definitely see you back here Monday night.